Bozell. He watches the media for a living, and he joins us right now. Do you see it that way? Tougher coverage than he deserves?
All right, let me give you some numbers here. And I want to stress here that nothing I'm about to say has been disputed. On May 9th, the New York Post reported that Hunter Biden had taken $20 million from the Kazakhs, the Romanians, the Ukrainians, the Russians, and the Chinese. Network news coverage, zero. On June 8th, Fox News confirmed that Joe Biden had taken $5 million from Burisma. Network news coverage, zero. James Comer came out with the report saying that the Biden family had been hiding this money through a web of 20 LLCs while not showing any work performed for that $20 million. Network news coverage, zero. August 17th, the New York Post came out with a story showing that Joe Biden was using the Robert Peters alias. Zero. The same day, James Comer released his report showing that Joe Biden was using numerous aliases. Network news coverage, zero. The story came out that there was a voicemail from Hunter to Joe saying, quote, I think you're in the clear. Network news coverage, zero. July 27th, the New York Post confirmed the big guy alias confirmation that was in that laptop where Joe Biden was going to get 10%. Network news coverage, zero. Hunter Biden's business partner, why would he be in the White House? Eric Schwimmer was there in the White House, confirmed 19 times. Network news coverage, zero. And my favorite, Mark Zuckerberg comes out and publicly declares the FBI put pressure on Facebook not to cover the Hunter Biden laptop story, which censorship cost Donald Trump the election. Network news coverage, zero. Now, what was that question again about them being too tough?
Yeah, okay, yeah. Point taken, Brent. Point taken. I'm going to move on to this. Op-ed in the New York Post, quote, nonstop media bias from Russiagate to the Biden crime family cover-up. Clearly, the media has been playing defense for Biden. We got that, and we got your report right there. Are there any signs at all that things are changing? I mean, they have been after him for his age and infirmity. Is that a sign of change on the part of the media?
No, simply go back to everything I just said. Ask yourself, if this were the Trump administration, at what point would they have started live coverage, breaking news live coverage, a la Brett Kavanaugh? With every single one of these touch points, it would have been breaking news. The same thing would have applied had it been George Bush 43, George Bush 45, Ronald Reagan, Richard Nixon, any Republican would get this kind of coverage. What I just gave you, Stuart, were about 10 different inflection points, all of which deserve national coverage. No, this thing is going to continue. This man is standing accused with evidence of bribery, of taking bribery from the Chinese government, the mortal enemy of the United States, and working on these deals through his son when he was vice president. If they can't cover that now, his age is irrelevant compared to the fact that real crimes, I think, have been committed for which this man should be going to prison.
Got it. Brent, you've covered it extensively, and that was pretty good coverage. Thanks for being with us this morning, Brent Bozell. Bozell, he watches the media for a living, and he joins us right now. Do you see it that way? Tougher coverage than he deserves?
All right, let me give you some numbers here. And I want to stress here that nothing I'm about to say has been disputed. On May 9th, the New York Post reported that Hunter Biden had taken $20 million from the Kazakhs, the Romanians, the Ukrainians, the Russians, and the Chinese. Network news coverage, zero. On June 8th, Fox News confirmed that Joe Biden had taken $5 million from Burisma. Network news coverage, zero. James Comer came out with the report saying that the Biden family had been hiding this money through a web of 20 LLCs while not showing any work performed for that $20 million. Network news coverage, zero. August 17th, the New York Post came out with a story showing that Joe Biden was using the Robert Peters alias. Zero. The same day, James Comer released his report showing that Joe Biden was using numerous aliases. Network news coverage, zero. The story came out that there was a voicemail from Hunter to Joe saying, quote, I think you're in the clear. Network news coverage, zero. July 27th, the New York Post confirmed the big guy alias confirmation that was in that laptop where Joe Biden was going to get 10%. Network news coverage, zero. Hunter Biden's business partner, Why would he be in the White House? Eric Schwimmer was there in the White House, confirmed 19 times. Network news coverage, zero. And my favorite, Mark Zuckerberg comes out and publicly declares the FBI put pressure on Facebook not to cover the Hunter Biden laptop story, which censorship cost Donald Trump the election. Network news coverage, zero. Now, what was that question again about them being too tough?
Yeah, okay, yeah. Point taken, Brent. Point taken. I'm going to move on to this. Op-ed in the New York Post, quote, nonstop media bias from Russiagate to the Biden crime family cover-up. Clearly, the media has been playing defense for Biden. We got that, and we got your report right there. Are there any signs at all that things are changing? I mean, they have been after him for his age and infirmity. Is that a sign of change on the part of the media?
No, simply go back to everything I just said. Ask yourself, if this were the Trump administration, at what point would they have started live coverage, breaking news, live coverage, a la Brett Kavanaugh? With every single one of these touch points, it would have been breaking news. The same thing would have applied had it been George Bush 43, George Bush 45, Ronald Reagan, Richard Nixon, any Republican would get this kind of coverage. What I just gave you, Stuart, were about 10 different inflection points, all of which deserve national coverage. No, this thing is going to continue. This man is standing accused with evidence of bribery, of taking bribery from the Chinese government, the mortal enemy of the United States, and working on these deals through his son when he was vice president. If they can't cover that now, his age is irrelevant compared to the fact that real crimes, I think, have been committed for which this man should be going to prison.
Got it. Brent, you've covered it extensively, and that was pretty good coverage. Thanks for being with us this morning, Brent Bozell.